At the start of this year, I wanted to release a video to tell you about some emerging technologies which Gartner has shared in their report of the year 2023. This video was to come early in the month of January, but unfortunately I missed this introduction footage and then I thought of scrapping this video. But then now I realize that maybe this could still add some value to it. So I'm adding this as an intro video. In this video, we'll talk about five such technology trends which will be in demand in the coming year, and not only in this year but in the coming decade as well. So go check it out. We'll also put the whole Gartner report where they have talked about multiple technologies apart from these five, but I personally feel these five will lead the way. So go check it out, and I really hope that this video will add some value to your existing knowledge. Thank you, and now here you go. So friends, Metaverse has been the buzzword for the last 1 or 2 years. Everyone is talking about Metaverse, especially when Mark Zuckerberg renamed Facebook to Meta. So Metaverse, in very simple word, is this virtual world where you could go in with your digital avatar and you could do things which you would do in your real life. And Metaverse is, you could say, a bouquet of multiple technologies. It includes blockchain, augmented reality, virtual reality, AI ML, Web 3.0. All these kind of different technologies coming together would build this whole metaverse, or you could say a digital world. And the end goal is that the digital world will become the new reality. But what kind of use cases we are targeting as far as the IT sector is concerned? So JP Morgan, the biggest investment bank, has recently invested $1 trillion in Decentraland, which is one of the famous platforms for metaverse, and they have opened their first online bank. So as a customer, you could virtually go into that bank and do transactions. Also, some other use cases are coming in real estate, wherein virtually you could visit a house or a property maybe in some other part of the world virtually and then buy it or sell it. Gaming again has various different kinds of use cases when it comes to metaverse. You could go and play online games. You could play tennis, for example, in a virtual lawn or a tennis court with someone sitting at some other part of the world. So there are numerous use cases. Metaverse is at a very nascent stage at this point of time, but by 2030 or 2035, you would see some very mature use cases of metaverse. So what we should do as technologists, we should be learning technologies which would form the bedrock of this whole paradigm. The very bedrock would be cloud, DevOps, SRE, all these kind of technologies would be needed to make metaverse a reality. So this is our very first trend. Now let's go to our second trend. The second technology trend is platform engineering, and unlike metaverse, this is way more mature as of today and maturing really fast. Platform engineering is all about improving developer experience and accelerating digital delivery. In today's world, we are so agile in developing anything that if you have a platform which has set of reusable tools and components, if a platform already has set of self-service technologies, tools and processes, then that platform becomes the backbone of your development team, and eventually it helps business to grow and to make changes really fast. In traditional enterprise IT companies, you never had those kind of platform teams, right? You always had siloed IT infrastructure, which was very difficult to manage. If you are building a new project, you might have to talk to different teams to get and build a product. But with platform engineering, you get everything in one package. And then as a developer, it's very easy for you to work with that particular platform. And as platform engineers, your job is to make sure that the platform is up and running, platform is healthy, platform is always in perfect shape so that the developers are doing their job. So we must discuss why platform engineering, what we were not doing earlier. I think we get confused with site reliability engineering. I understand site reliability engineering is somewhat similar to platform engineering, but then platform engineering goes a step further, includes everything with site reliability engineering, because that is a very DevOps kind of a principle. But platform engineering is about building a common platform for all your agile deliveries, and you push all the kind of reusable softwares, reusable tools and processes, and some self-service applications so that developers are empowered. So what kind of skills you would need if you want to be with this particular trend?
Obviously, cloud, DevOps, SRE, scripting, a bit of coding knowledge is required if you want to become a platform engineer. Linux knowledge, agile development knowledge. You could become a scrum master and still work in platform engineering as a scrum master. So this trend is expected to modernize the enterprise IT and the way we are delivering software. So let's get on to the third trend. The third trend I would say is less of a technology trend, but more of a business trend, because now from cloud platforms, we will be moving towards industry specific cloud platforms. Now, what does that mean? Today, we think of all the cloud providers as a one big umbrella where every industry sits right now. But as we are moving ahead, industries need specific solutions curated for their specific needs. And that's why now all the cloud providers are building customized industry specific cloud solutions for that particular industry. And that is all to convert these cloud platforms into a business platform. So for example, we have Azure, GCP, AWS, and we have different industries sitting inside a cloud, right? Manufacturing, banking, retail, media. So instead of putting everything in one basket, we will have specific baskets of industry specific solutions. But from technology perspective, I would say we are very much on the course. There is nothing new which we have to learn. We have to just focus on building our skills on all the different cloud platforms, be it Amazon, Oracle, Google Cloud, Azure. So nothing changes from that perspective, but the mindset shift is from the business end. But it's better to know that this is happening, so that if you are a domain expert, for example, who know nothing about technology, for example, if you have been working in manufacturing sector for a long time, now you, the kind of domain experts who are core into their sector would be very important, because when these solutions would be deployed for a specific industry, those kind of domain experts would be needed more. So yes, for those kind of skill sets, for those kind of people who are domain experts, this is a good opportunity for them to learn cloud and shape their career. So let's go on. So the fourth technology trend is AI TRISM. It's a unique word which stands for artificial intelligence, and TRISM stands for trust, risk, security, management. Now, why we need this? So we all understand and accept that artificial intelligence has a great potential. But what's lacking is a kind of a control structure or a governance structure around artificial intelligence. Because businesses are not gaining that confidence that although they see value in artificial intelligence projects, they do not trust it fully to be a production ready solution. And that's why they are coming up with this framework where artificial intelligence with all its capability would also have its checks and balances with the governance structure around it. How it will help? First of all, it will give reliability, governance, privacy, transparency, everything to a model. Any AI model has to be self-reliant in production. It has to keep evolving. We cannot risk a business depending on something we tested in dev or quality environments on our model, right? Business could not bet so high. That's why they need a control system which ensures that AI models are managing those risks and are completely transparent to the business. Also, businesses treat artificial intelligence as a black box because they are not technologists. They don't know much about what's happening in data science, how we do our machine learning models, how we train the models. They are actually looking for a business value. So with AI TRISM, we are trying to open up this Pandora box or this black box of artificial intelligence to the business, so they really understand what kind of value we are delivering out of artificial intelligence. We will do it using strong documentation and control. Anything which is happening in production in artificial intelligence has to be monitored very closely. It has to be audited very closely. So the end goal of AI TRISM is to move all the AI projects from unmanaged risk towards managed risk. Now, what kind of skills you could learn in order to be with this trend? All the different AI skills. I cannot name those now because I have discussed this previously a number of times. But apart from those AI ML skills, the additional skills which would be needed would be around cybersecurity, because you need to understand how the security and privacy of these models will be maintained, how the data security will be maintained, whether these AI models would be susceptible or vulnerable to some sort of a data theft, for example. The other skill which will be needed is around IT governance. People who have worked in PMO office, who have worked in IT governance department would come in handy to shape these all different processes and controls for AI TRISM. So yes, this is our fourth trend. Now let's move on to our last and the final trend. The fifth one in our list is wireless value realization. Just to give you some fact, today, only 15% of wireless devices are delivering value-added services or something more than basic network connectivity. But by the year 2025, 50% of these devices would deliver more business value than basic connectivity. And it is all because of this value realization which we are targeting. Today, with the advent of technologies like 5G, 6G, 7G, IoT, edge computing, it has become really easy, fast and efficient to connect to these edge devices which are having really useful data and use it directly into our business value chain. So value realization for wireless is all about moving from pure network connectivity towards delivering direct business value. For example, if a farmer is growing some vegetable and wants to sell it into a different market, into a different geography, using these sensor devices, the farmer could now track the freshness of his or her vegetables right through that supply chain at different points till the point it is sold to the customer. Those kind of use cases, and there could be numerous other use cases in which we just not focus on connecting with an edge device or a wireless device, but rather gain a lot of value addition. And that's what is the focus of this particular technology trend. Now, as technologists, these are some technologies which we should focus on. 5G, 6G, 7G, wireless communication, networking, IoT, edge computing, all these different technologies would be the fundamental base for this particular trend. So if you are interested, if you are coming from a telecommunication background, if you are from a networking background with wireless experience, you could excel in this particular career with addition of some additional skills which are mentioned here. And apart from that, obviously, cloud computing and other skills which will be needed to excel in this area. So guys, this brings us to the end of this video. I hope you now know a bit about these five trends. Apart from this, there are several other trends which are coming, but these five trends resonated the most with me. So I have thought of sharing it with you. If you got any value out of this video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon, so you exactly know when I upload my next video. And until next time, guys, keep learning, keep sharing all the knowledge, and yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.